A very good morning. I think this is an interesting session, but what takes away the punch is not many audience here. I am sure these kind of instruction courses are, I think they should be kept on day which is a non-Sunday and not the last day, because the carry home message these sessions have is far more greater than the other sessions. But anyway, I'll be talking about capsule or excess. If you understand the basics and physics of capsule or excess, it will actually make a large difference in the way you manage your complications. Let's first of all understand the anatomy of the capsule. The capsule is thickest at the point of the anterior most insertion of the zonules. So if you keep your capsule excess well within the 5 to 7 millimeter zone, the chances of it running away are high, not less. Now, but the moment you cross this zone, you encroach more on the zonules, and the zonules would want to pull back your excess and pull it out. So the capsular excess safest zone would be safe zone of 6 millimeters. Ye kya ho raha boss?
Yeah, this is a problem.
Yeah. So let us understand the capsular excess is like a trampoline, and the zonules are like those elastics on a trampoline. If you are working with the safe zone, it is maintaining a proper stretch. If you understand the physics, for my friends who understand me and know me, I'm a man of physics. I apply physics in any surgery I do. If you bifurcate the forces, the capsular excess management will work on two forces, the centrifugal forces and the centripetal forces. And the net sum of them will give a tangential force. So if you increase this force, the excess will come in. And if this force increases, the excess will go out. But if you balance these two forces and give a direction, then the excess will go along the tangent. So the viscoelastic plays a big, big role in increasing your centripetal force. If you push in more viscoelastic on the capsule, you flatten the capsule. The capsule flattening pulls the excess inside. So your centripetal force increases. But when the anterior chamber flattens, the zonules pull out the capsule excess, your centrifugal force increases. That's what happens in an intralenticular pressure rise of a phacomorphic cataract or a pure white cataract. Because the intralenticular pressure is high, the zonules are pulling it outward, so the centrifugal force makes an Argentinian flag sign. Now, increased centrifugal forces, as I said, will always pull the excess out. Now, when do you have increased centrifugal forces? If the zonules are encroached, if the viscoelastic is leaking from the anterior chamber, or in a hypermature cataract when the intralenticular pressure is high. That's when the zonules are pulling the capsular excess outwards. Okay. Another second thing to now monitor is two principles. One is the centrifugal centripetal force, and then the net sum of the anterior chamber pressure should always be greater than the intralenticular pressure plus vitreous pressure, which again says viscoelastic in the anterior chamber, or any time when your anterior chamber is at a higher pressure, you're in a safer zone. In hypermature cataracts, there's increased pressure here, and as this pressure increases, it pushes the zonules to actually pull it more. Now, this is how the pressure is transmitted. When you're doing capsular excess, you push the wound downwards, viscoelastic leaks, and as the viscoelastic leaks, the zonules, the pressure in the anterior chamber is lower, the lens diaphragm moves forward, zonules are stretched, capsular excess goes out. So, bottom rule, now we will see anterior bulge of the capsule has to be flattened. The capsule is always like this anteriorly. If you flatten it, you will be in control. But the moment the bulge starts increasing, it'll go out. Now let us see the points of note: size of runout, site of runout, edge, whether it's visible or not, capsule type, cataract type, all these things will decide. Now I'll just go very fast with some videos. Now this is a situation where the capsular excess has actually run out sub-incisionally. So what did I do first? I pushed in viscoelastic, I flattened the capsule, and now with one jerk, one radial force and one tangential force. And see, it has to be with a jerk. If you go slowly, it'll catch another zonule, and it'll go out. So just do it. Hold it, push it radially, and then make a tangential force. So when you do this, you'll always be in the safe zone. I'll just keep showing you very short videos now. Now, this is a very tricky situation. Sub-incisional, complete peripheral run out. How to actually get it back in control. I'll just keep showing these 30-second videos. Again, very tricky situation. It is out. I pushed in viscoelastic. There's a good intra amount of anterior chamber pressure. First radial pressure, and as the excess starts extending, just pull it inwards towards the center. Once that is done, it comes back in control. When you see another case, now in case you have a sharp edge, you are doing a rexis, and while doing a rexis, you've left a sharp edge, meaning there is a V-cut shape towards outside. Always get it round back again, because this will extend into a posterior capsular tear. So we will see this video. This is the clear lens extraction. We start the rexis. Rexis is starting. I'm jumping. See now. It's a comfortable case. Everything is going fine. Rexis is going. It slightly goes out of control here. Again, now I get it in. But what have I done? I've created a sharp edge here. There's a sharp edge here. If you leave it, you may even complete your rexis. Especially if the rexis is small and you have a sharp edge. This edge will have a tendency to go rupture out. So even once you've completed your capsular rexis, it's always an idea to go back and complete that sharp edge back to round again. Don't leave it sharp. This pointing edge outwards is a recipe for disaster. It'll come and trouble you when you're probably so engrossed doing your phaco. Now this is a situation. Next case is very interesting. Similar situation. I'm called by one of my junior associates. He says, sir, rexis tear ho gaya hai, piche chala gaya hai. He was recording it. So he tried to manage it, make it round. So he said, sir, maine shayad round kar diya, pakka nahi hai. But what problem was occurred is, now you see what happens. He's trying to complete it. So anyway, I come and manage it. I start the surgery and see what happens. Because by then it's a big mess. There's so much of cortex there. I don't know where the capsule is. Now the cataract I've operated and see. I'll just forward it. I'll just forward it. See. The thing has extended back. Which means there was no rounding off. He probably just pulled it and extended it more and handed the case to me saying, sir, probably complete ho gaya. My mistake. I took his word. I should have stopped. Washed the viscoelastic, put in trypan blue, identified the capsular margins and then gone ahead. But nevertheless, lesson learned. Now this is another situation. Capsular rex has gone out. Now it is going out. Again, intralenticular pressure is high. Viscoelastic is in. See, the mistake. Mistake is, I am not monitoring the viscoelastic leak. The viscoelastic is leaking. The moment a bubble comes out, the pressure is low and the rexis extends out. So bottom line, whenever anterior chamber pressure is going down, the rexis centripetal forces will come in and they'll put. So how do you manage it? Extend it. Give a linear cut, but don't give a very linear cut so that you encroach another tangential area. Smaller linear cut, again viscoelastic in the anterior chamber, now round it off again. And once you round it off again, lower the intralenticular pressure by taking out the fluffy cortical matter in this and then start the surgery. So once this is done, so again, I'll show you very, very interesting situations. Again, rexis is run out and intralenticular pressure is high. How do you manage this? This completely gone to the periphery. Again, so trick is this tag will bother you. Round it off with 1 hour. I have a sharp edge here, but since I'm the one who's operating, I know that what kind of pressures I have to maintain in the anterior chamber. If you put in too much of viscoelastic in this, then you will again extend it. So it's a balanced situation. Don't increase the bottle height in this situation. Do not come in, come out again and again, because the shallowing, deepening of the chamber will extend this V tear. Once you go in, finish the surgery and then come out once. So again, very interesting situation here. Now this is interesting. While doing the surgery, the blade went in. It's a topical surgery. I made the port and see what has happened. The blade has gone inside the eye. And I have cut like this, straight and tear. Intralenticular pressure.
Kamal, now to summarize.
Okay.
We have plenty of
videos. I have two flaps. I'll just finish after this. I have two flaps. The blade has gone inside the capsule. It was a topical surgery. Patient moved his head. Now how to manage this? Push in viscoelastic, evert both the flaps, try and pull. I'm pulling, I see no, this will extend. I try, extend. So I go in with the 1 hour. I make two cuts on the side, tangential cuts. Now these are things which I want the juniors to learn. You know, these are situations where you can come out very easily if you understand the physics and the dynamics of capsular rexis. I made two linear cuts, join them, join this one from here and join that one from there and have a complete capsule access. I have plenty more videos to show.
Yeah, I know. So Kamal very well demonstrated. Any questions from Kamal? Because this capsule access is the first point where we have to achieve success to proceed for the FACO.
Of the capsule also has a role because in children,
of course,
the capsule.
You saw the third slide. I skipped it because I don't have much time.
Yeah.
The nature of the capsule is very different. That's why I said the sight, the size, the nature, the cataract characteristic, everything matters. In children, you will aim for a smaller rexus and you'll get a bigger rexus. And a lot of times, if it starts running out, it is very difficult to come back again. Of course, you have a valid point, sir. Thank you. Thank you, sir.